Hi, my name is Jared Broad, and in this bootcamp, we're going to be going over buy and hold with a trailing stop. You're going to learn how to place a stop market order, how to update it, how to access the price data from your algorithm. So, let's start with the first task, setting up a stop market order. Just like other orders, stop orders can be called with a helper method that's provided in on your algorithm. Stop market order, where you pass in the ticket, the quantity, and the price that you want the stop to be set at. So for this task, it's asking us to use daily data with raw data normalization mode. So let's request some daily data. And if you remember, we have to save the security object and update the data normalization mode on that security object. Okay, great, part one done. So next is saying, use the market order to buy 500 units of SPY if the portfolio is not yet invested. So we can do that using what we learned in the first bootcamp tasks. And if we're not invested, let's place the market order. So it's saying for SPY and 500 units. And then finally it's saying create a stop market order to sell those shares if the SPY is at 90% of the current price. So we can copy the helper here. And if SPY, we want to sell 500. And if you note here that we're using the negative to sell it, so there is no difference between buying and selling with QuantConnect, it's just the quantity of shares that you're ordering. And we want to place it for 90% of the SPY's current price. So here in self.securities, you've got a collection of the security objects, and close is the last close price for SPY. Okay, let's submit our answer and see how it goes. Okay, great. First task done. Let's move on to the next one. So here we're going to be working with order events. When you place an order, there's a number of things that happen. The order is first checked, it's transmitted to your brokerage, it can then be invalidated by your brokerage or accepted, and then it can be filled over time, or it sits in your brokerage and waits to be filled. So in this case, we've got this on order event method, which if you override and you write code there, you'll receive the events as they happen related to your orders. So when you submit an order, you can then listen for that order being filled and the events related to it. So here it's saying inside our on-order event handler, check if the incoming order has been completely filled. So you can know if it's been completely filled by the order status. So we say if this order event is related to the order we just placed. So we can copy this bar here. And then the next part is saying if there's been a fill, we can then save it to the last order event property. And then it's asking us to use the debug statement to print out the order ID. So just as with all debug messages, you need to convert it to a string before you can use it. And then on that order event, there's an order ID property here. So we print out the order ID for those trades that we've placed. So let's see if that'll work. Cool. So if you notice here in the console, you can see 1, 2, and 4. So there's been a number of different trades placed over the life of the algorithm. And you can see here in the background behind the task, the equity curve is almost continuous. If we were using a stop market order, we might expect to see some flat periods where the stop had been filled and there were no trades because your stop had just been filled. But for some reason, it's moving continuously. So that'll probably be addressed in the next one. So the problem with the last one was that as soon as the stop was filled, it would liquidate all of our holdings. And then at the very next day, we would place another order. So we need to have some sort of control over our algorithm to see and make sure that it's not placing trades immediately after the stop was filled. The right way to do this in QuantConnect, and the right way to track orders in general, is with order tickets. Order tickets are kind of like a Coke ticket. They're a reference to your order that you can come back to, you can update the price, you can cancel the order, you can know its fill price, all via this order ticket reference. The first task is to create this stop market order for 90% of SPY, and then save the resulting order ticket returned to the stop market ticket property. So when you place an order, the value that's returned is that order ticket. So let's go for number one, create the stop loss. And we want to save it to stop market ticket. Okay, cool. So part one done. We're going to be saving the result of the stop market order to this property stop market ticket. Next part. In the order ID, match the ID of the incoming order with the stop market order that we just saved. Okay. So first thing you can notice here that there's a little bit of code to say that if it's not equal to a filled status event, because there's so many other status messages that come through, you might want to filter them out and only pay attention to the filled status messages. So here it's saying if the stop market ticket is not none. This has also been written for us. So what this means is we need to check that it's not none. So if you don't have the stop market ticket placed yet, it could feasibly be none. And then if we try to use it, it's going to result in an error. So let's see. So if it's not none, and the order ID, so you can see here it's saying we should be comparing the order event ID with the stop market ticket order ID. And then the final part, if they match, store the date time into stop market fill time. Okay. If you remember from the previous tasks, self.time is the current time in the algorithm in the backtest. So we can save that if the order has been filled and the order ID matches, then we're going to save that time. And then finally, last but not least, let's use this little helper here. We want to make sure that we're not placing orders immediately after the stop market was filled. So we need to check if some sort of minimum time has passed. So we're going to say every in the on data, if the self.time minus stop market fill time is less than 15 days, meaning we've filled the stop market order within the last 2 weeks, then we're just going to return and don't place any trades. Okay, see how we go. It's important to be really paying attention to the trades that your algorithm makes in backtesting. It can be tempting to gloss over it because it's covering a long period of time and there's many, many orders. But if you don't really pay attention, it can be doing things that you don't quite expect. So what we might expect to see here are periods where there are no trading because we've just said that we don't want it to trade for 15 days after a stop was hit. So we can see that here, that we placed an order, and the stop was hit, and we have this long flat period where there was no trading activity, and then we started trading again. So that's just as we expect. So on to the next one. So the next very common request for QuantConnect is to have a trailing stop. This can be done with QuantConnect by using the update field on an order ticket. You just need to save the order ticket and then call update to update that property, the stop price. So we have these fields, update order fields, which contain all the information that you want to put into an update. So here in the objectives, we need to check if the current spy price is higher than the highest price. A trailing stop is simply moving the stop price up as the highest price moves higher. So to do that, we need to save the highest price. So here, if you want to make a new highest price for the asset, you need to save that highest price as you move along. So we're going to save the new highest price. And then finally, let's print out that highest price to see how it's going. And then remember to use the string helper there to convert the highest price. So here it's saying, I actually skipped over this part. See, it says update the stop price to 90% of the highest price. So to do that, we're going to need to use these update fields here. So we've got the new highest price for SPY, and let's update the price. So here we're creating a new instance of this object, and we're setting the stop price here to 90% of the SPY, and then we're going to set it in here to the stock market ticket update using that update fields object we just created. And just with that little bit of code, we can update that price dynamically as it's in market. Let's see how we go. Okay, cool. Pass the task, but if we just want to look a little deeper, we can see here that the algorithm high price was printed, indicating that we've detected a new high for our order. Okay, on to the next task. Sometimes, if you're just using the console and logging to debug and try and understand your algorithm, it can be helpful to use our plotting features so that you get a more visual representation for the algorithm. So to do that, we've created the self.plot, which is a one-line piece of code that you can plot any data. So the first part of it is the chart name, and then the next part is the series name. And then finally, there's the value you'd like to plot. So using that, you can create a new chart, create a new line on that chart, and then plot that data. So the first task is to create a new data chart with a series called asset price. And now here we need to plot the SPY closing price. So we can do that just like this. Cool. Number one done. Now we need to plot the moving stop price to the stop price series on the same chart. So we can reuse most of this. And if you remember, the stop price is set to 90% of the highest price. And we need to plot it to a series called stop price. Let's see how we go. You notice we've made the plot here before the if statement because we want to make sure we're plotting every time. If we put it inside the if statement here, it would only be plotting when the close price moves higher. There we go, we've done it. We've passed the buy and hold with the trailing stop bootcamp on QuantConnect. Thank you very much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next lesson.